Hey guys, Matty Extreme Auto Caravan and Camping with you again today. Beautiful day here in Adelaide, sunny, look. Got a 12 pin issue on this MUX. Got the apprentice working, fitting an Anderson system on it, and we've come across something really crap. I have to show it to you, so check this out. So the customer's got their vehicle wired up for the AES circuits for their three-way fridge in their brand new Windsor. And our mate's having a few issues with it. So we're fitting an Anderson plug on this MUX. So I always like to inspect other people's work. It's just a bit of a habit I've got doing. And check this out. Woohoo! How good's that, guys? That's an absolute winner. Chicken dinner. So the problem we've got here, obviously, is number one, they've run an 8BNS solid line, so it's direct via a MIDI fuse. Used a MIDI fuse, that's really good, which is really good. But they've split the 8BNS. They've literally just gone, they've cut it in half and run it into 11 and 12. So, number one, it's not even in the right pin. Number two, it's split, so there's constant power going to both pins. One's the AES trigger wire, which is pin 12. Pin 11 is brake safe charging. And pin 8, which is that pissy little thin cable, and pin 10, which is supposed to be a nice thick earth, it's not done right. So number one, the wire's been split, it's the wrong one. That needs to go to the high current side, because that is the high current wire, the thick wire. Pin 10, the earth return, needs to be the same gauge cable, and it's not. They've just used the factory, you know, white wire, which is very thin, not good enough to run a three-way fridge, you know, 6 or 7 meters away. And the AES trigger wire hasn't been run, they've just split it. So what'll happen with this setup, and I don't even need to plug the van in to see what's gonna happen, you're gonna plug this 12 pin in and the fridge is gonna come on 12 volts straight away, pulling, I don't know how it's gonna pull the current out of this, but anyway, as soon as they plug it in, it's gonna turn on, and straight away without even starting the car. So the AES trigger wire isn't run and it's not wired up correctly, so he's gonna get a flat battery. If he stops at a ferry, stops for fuel, stops on the side of the road for any given amount of time, he's going to have a dead flat battery. Horrible. So, you know, the fridges are over $2,000 for a reason. And they're not like that because the D plus wire, the AES trigger wire, is there for that reason. It needs to see signal. It'll tell the fridge to pull high current from the high current circuit. It'll start pulling it while the engine's running, turn the key off, hit the button, whatever, shut the engine down, and it will stop. 15 minutes later, the fridge will go tick, 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 and try to ignite off gas. Now, that's a standard. That's what your automatic fridge is supposed to do when the vehicle is wired up correctly. And in this case, not. So here we are at the 12 pin end on the Windsor. And as you can see, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So there's your 10, earth return. 9 high current for the fridge. You've got your AES trigger wire on that 11 there, that little thin grey one. And then you've got brake safe charging on pin 12. So corresponding in a vehicle done incorrectly, and you know, you just have problems. It's just not wired properly. So there you go.